Welcome to the SlideGettings Tech Simplified channel. Have you ever wanted to leverage a hardware token to authenticate in your Azure AD account? If the answer is yes, keep watching this video until the end. The first thing I had to do was procure an actual hardware token. I didn't want a token that would lock me into a vendor. I wanted a third-party token that I can use on here with Azure AD. And I went with Token 2 just because their user experience and their buying experience was a lot simpler than the other ones I took a look at. And I didn't want to have to use another app. I just wanted to use the hardware token and get it done. So that's why I didn't go with a FIDO2 token. The Token 2 C202 token, hardware token, gets the job done, right? The only complaint I had is it took a little time to get to me, about 3 weeks. But the company is based in Switzerland. I'm living in Buffalo, New York. It took about 3 weeks. Granted, we're going through COVID-19, so that probably added to the delay. But without that, it was pretty good experience. The one thing I did like about what Token 2 did is they have a step-by-step guide on how do you implement it. And this made it super easy for me to implement it. So you can go through this link and see exactly what you need to do. So the one area that I just need to spell out to you is you're going to have to change that UPN and substitute it into your name of your account for your Azure AD account that you're leveraging. But I want to let you know which hardware token I went to and why. So let's take a look at some of the prereqs from the Microsoft side. So before we get started, we got two prereqs that we need to follow so we can enable and leverage our hardware token for authentication method. So the first thing is ensuring we have the correct licenses. So you're going to need to have either Azure AD P1 license or P2 license. And then the second thing is the right role and permissions. I'm leveraging a global admin. You could be a security administrator. And there's a few other ones that you can leverage as well. First thing we're going to do is go to authentication methods. And then we're going to click on to enable users for combined security info registration experience. And then we're going to select the second one here that says users can use the combined security information registration experience. This is going to allow our users to be able to do some self-registration and configure their keys. You don't have to do this. I like doing this because it allows the user to dictate which one they want to leverage, right? So you could do it for employees, or I'm going to do it in this case for all of our employees. Once that's done, we're going to go back to security, go to MFA, and then here we're going to go on OAuth tokens. So if you already purchased that token and you leveraged that Token 2 token, you reached out to them, you got the email, it has your seed. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to have to upload a file there, right? And when you upload that file, it's going to ask you for a few different information. You're going to have to change that UPN number and add in, like in my case, the SGittens and my email account for my organization. And then it's going to take in the other information right there for you. So once you do that, the next thing we're going to have to do is configure the self-service sign-on piece, and then you'll be all set. So let's get into that next. So you saw the prereqs, you saw what type of token I went with, the Token 2 token, and you saw the experience in terms of taking a look at where you need to upload that CSV file, changing the UPN number, adding your token. It's now registered. So now let's take a look at the end user experience and see how you can leverage it with other tokens as well. So the first thing you want to make sure that you have there is that hardware token, the type, serial number. If you end up not using that hardware token anymore, you can also delete it. A key thing that you have to do here is make sure you change. So you have the default method is that hardware token that you leverage in your account. So what if you lose your hardware token or misplace it or left it at home? You could assign it with something else. So as long as you have your cell phone, you can receive that text message or a PIN code. So now let's go take a look at actually signing in with a hardware token. So let's sign into my account leveraging this hardware token. So you can see on the screen, please type in the code displayed on your authenticator app from your device. So I'm going to be using this hardware token right here and typing in this number. So let's go ahead and do that. Keep me signing now. And it was that simple. I signed in with my hardware token and it was that seamless. It didn't take too long. The longest part in this whole entire thing was waiting for my token to arrive. But outside of that, everything else was pretty smooth.
I just used a hardware token to authenticate into my Azure AD account. Wasn't that pretty cool? Now what I want you to do is go take a look at the other videos within my channel And make sure you subscribe and click the bell to stay notified to never miss a video that I release. Well, until next time, Sly Gittins is out.